1 p.m. Assalamu alaikum. This is Radio Pakistan. The news read by Friha Hassan. The headlines. Meeting of the Federal Cabinet is underway in Islamabad with Prime Minister in the chair. Finance Minister says a strong audit institution is a prerequisite for ensuring transparency and good governance in the country. Pakistan is facilitating efforts for a International Kabaddi Takara begins in Bahawalpur today. And now the news in detail. Meeting of the Federal Cabinet is underway in Islamabad with Prime Minister Imran Khan in the chair. The meeting is discussing its agenda items pertaining to matters of national and international importance. Finance Minister Asad Umar says the government will strengthen all institutions, including the Office of Auditor General, for implementing its election manifesto of a new Pakistan. Addressing a seminar on Pak-China audit systems in Islamabad today, he said it is necessary to carry out all public transactions in utmost transparent manner. The finance minister said an efficient and a strong audit institution is a prerequisite for ensuring transparency and good governance in the country.
People of Pakistan paid their taxes, and it is our responsibility to try and ensure that that money is spent honestly, prudently, and effectively. And the Auditor General's organization has a vital role to play in that.
The finance minister said China has a very effective audit system which has helped it in eradicating corruption. Asad Umar said Pakistan can also learn a lot from the Chinese audit system to improve its audit institution and eliminate corruption from society. President has accepted the resignation of Federal Minister for Science and Technology, Azam Sawati. A notification to this effect has been issued by the Cabinet. The resignation will be effective from 6th of last month, the day on which he had tendered his resignation. Islamabad High Court will hear former Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif's appeal for suspension of sentence in Al Azizia reference case on 21st of this month. A two-member bench of the court comprising Justice Amir Farooq and Justice Mohsen Akhtar Kayani ordered the registrar office yesterday to fix the appeal for hearing. PTI leader Khurram Sher Zaman has withdrawn from Election Commission his application seeking disqualification of PPP co-chairman Asif Ali Zardari. During the proceedings at Election Commission in Islamabad today, Khurram Sher Zaman sought a retraction of his application, saying he will pursue the case at a higher forum, which is Supreme Court. Foreign Office spokesperson Dr. Mohammad Faisal says Pakistan is facilitating efforts for a peaceful solution to the Afghan issue. In a tweet today, he said Pakistan believes that an intra-Afghan dialogue is the only way to a successful negotiated settlement. A top Afghan official has acknowledged the sincerity of present Pakistani government in peace process in Afghanistan. In an interview with BBC, Afghan President Ashraf Ghani's special envoy for regional affairs, Muhammad Umar Daud Zai, said the new government in Islamabad and military are on the same page, especially on peace and security issues. He said it is comfortable in this situation for Afghanistan to discuss issues with Pakistan. To a question about postponement of talks between Afghan Taliban and U.S. officials in Doha, Umar Daud Zai said no talks have so far been scheduled. He said neither Afghanistan nor the United States have any information about the talks, and it is the Taliban who are issuing such statements to media. In occupied Kashmir, senior APHC leader and chairman Tehreek-e-Hurriyat Jammu and Kashmir, Mohammad Ashraf Sahrai, has urged the international community to build pressure on India to resolve the Kashmir dispute in accordance with the Kashmiris' aspirations. Mohammad Ashraf Sahrai, in a statement in Srinagar, expressed serious concern over the prevailing grim situation in the occupied territory. Meanwhile, all Sikh Sarpanch and points of Pulwama district have tendered their resignations following the killing of a member of the Sikh community by unidentified gunmen in Taral area. The International Kabaddi Takara begins at Drink Stadium in Bahawalpur today. Two matches will be played on the opening day today. In the first match, Iran will face India, while in the second match, Pakistan Green will play against Pakistan White. World soccer stars Luis Figo of Portugal and Mestre Kaka of Brazil have arrived in Karachi via Dubai. They will also visit Lahore and participate in football matches. On arrival at Karachi airport, the two soccer stars said they are excited to visit Pakistan. And that is the end of this news bulletin. For more news and analyses, log on to our website radio.gov.pk and also watch live video streaming of our bulletins on the link facebook.com/radiopakistannewsofficial.